Right. Now we shall see an example based on the indefinite integration where partial fractions are involved and provided Q of x as repeated linear factors. And remember carefully, here always degree of P of x is less than degree of Q of x. Now if you could observe carefully, 3x minus 2 is one linear factor and x plus 1 is also a linear factor, but repeated for 2 times. So what I'll be doing means, I will consider the given function. What is the given function? Let 3x minus 5 divided by 3x minus 2 into x plus 1 whole square. So partial fraction shall be writing totally one, this particular factor is repeated for 2 times and this is another linear factor. So we need how many constants? 3 constants. So what happens? A by 3x minus 2 plus B by x plus 1 plus C by x plus 1 whole square. So finally, what I'll be doing, that implies 3x minus 5 is equal to, if I take LCM, I think everything will be getting cancelled. A into, so here comes what, x plus 1 whole square plus B into x plus 1 into 3x minus 2 plus C into, comes here 3x minus 2. So now I need to calculate the value of A, B, C. For calculating the value of A, B, C, for my convenience, I'll be putting x is equal to minus 1. If I put x is equal to minus 1, what happens? LHS becomes 3 into minus 1 minus 5. So that becomes minus 8. This becomes 0 because x ki jagah mein minus 1 rakhe to a 0 aa jayega. And this also becomes 0. And this becomes C into minus 3 minus 2. So finally what happened? I think this becomes minus 5. Here minus 8. Minus 8, minus minus will be getting cancelled. So what happens? 8 is equal to 5C. So what happens? C, I will be getting it as 8 by 5. So I got the value of C. So now later what I will be doing? I want to find the value of B. So or some other value of A. For that what I will be doing? I will be putting x is equal to 2 by 3. Because 3x minus 2 is there. As 3x minus 2 is there, I'll put 3x minus 2 is equal to 0 means x is equal to 2 by 3. So this part becomes 0, this part becomes 0, and this doesn't become 0. So from that I can get the value of A. So what happens? That becomes 3 into, in place of x, I'll be writing 2 by 3 minus 5 is equal to, in place of A, I'll be writing it as 2 by 3 plus 1 whole square. So here 3, 3 will be getting cancelled. 2 minus 5 means minus 3 is equal to 2 by 3 plus 1. 2 by 3 plus 1 is 5 by 3. 5 by 3 whole square means it becomes as A into 25 by 9. So what happens? That implies cross multiplication. This becomes minus 27. So here what I'll be getting? A is equal to minus 27 by 25. Now I got the value of C. I got the value of A, but finally I need to find the value of B. For finding the value of B, I will suggest you one thing. You put x is equal to 0, so that we will be getting an expression in terms of A plus B plus C. So our method also becomes easy. So what I'll be getting? Put x is equal to 0. If I put x is equal to 0, LHS becomes minus 5. This becomes A, because A into 0 plus 1 whole square is 0. I kept x is equal to 0, so LHS I got minus 5, and 0 plus 1 whole square means I got as A. And here also if you could observe carefully, x ki jagah mein 0 rakhe to B into 0 plus 1 into 0 minus 2. So this becomes A minus 2B, x ki jagah mein 0 substitute kare to. Here also when I substitute x is equal to 0, that becomes minus 2c. So finally what happens? That implies minus 5 is equal to, in place of A, minus 27 by 25 and minus 2b, and in place of C, 2 into 8 by 5 means 16 by 5. So finally what happens, we should be very, very careful in calculations. Minus 5, I think everywhere I will cancel minus. So what happens, 5 is equal to 27 by 25 plus 16 by 5. So 27 by 25 plus 16 by 5 plus 2b. So finally what happens, that implies 5 is equal to, here 25 is LCM, so 27 plus 80 means 107 by 25 plus 2b. So finally what happens, here I am writing the value of b. So what happens, 2b is equal to 5 minus 107 by 25. So again LCM is 25 is a 125 minus 107 is 18 by 25. But here this is 2b, 2b is equal to 18 by 25. So what happens, b is equal to 9 by 25. So if you could observe carefully, I got the value of a, I got the value of b, and I got the value of c. So directly I need to substitute in this particular expression. So I think if you copy all these things, I'll be substituting here. So please copy. Right, now I'll be substituting. So in place of a, what I'll be writing? In place of a, I'll be writing minus 27 by 25. Later, in place of b, what I'll be writing? 9 by 25. And in place of c, what I'll be writing? 8 by 5. So finally I need to do integration. How will be integration means apply integral on both the sides. So therefore integral of 3x minus 5 by x minus 2 into x plus 1 whole square is equal to integral of nothing is there, means here clearly understood it is dx. I am not writing every time. So minus 27 by 25, there remains 1 by 3x minus 2 dx, and here 9 by 25 into 1 by x plus 1 dx plus 8 by 5 into integral of 1 by x plus 1 whole square dx. So finally what happens, minus 27 by 25 integral of, it is like 1 by x means log mod 3x minus 2, but whatever coefficient of x is there, that comes to denominator, and here 9 by 25 integral of 1 by x plus 1 means log mod x plus 1, and here also it is like 1 by x square means minus 1 by x. So minus 8 by 5 into x plus 1 on the whole c. So any cancellation is there means we can do it. So here 3 ones are 3 nines are. So finally what happens, minus 9 by 25 minus 9 by 25, or else what I'll be doing means just I'll write 9 by 25. Here it is like log m minus log n. So log of x plus 1 by 3x minus 2 minus 8 by 5 into x plus 1 plus c. Now we shall be seeing problems based on application of partial fractions in indefinite integration, where denominator means here I call it as q of x, involves some quadratic factors. I'll go by an example. Always remember, here degree of numerator should be less than degree of denominator. So degree of numerator should be less than degree of denominator. So here if suppose p of x by quadratic factor means x square plus x plus 1 is there, into some linear factor x plus 1. So how can you write this particular function ka partial fractions, means forgets about for some time about this particular integral symbol, x square plus x plus 1. I think this is irreducible. Irreducible means where we cannot factorize. Whenever we are not able to factorize, for that particular quadratic expression, the partial expression should be taken as ax plus b divided by x square plus x plus 1, and another constant for this particular linear factor, and this should be taken as c upon x plus 1. This is a rule and you should remember. I'll go by another example. Example 2. If suppose p of x divided by this time x square minus x minus 7 into again here x square 3x square minus 2x minus 25, like this is there. And if suppose another one x plus 10 is there. Here we are having how many quadratic expressions? This is a quadratic expression, this is a quadratic expression, this is a linear expression. Corresponding to this particular quadratic expression, I will take ax plus b divided by x square minus x minus 7, and again corresponding to this particular second quadratic expression, I need to write a partial fraction of the same form but with different constants. So cx plus d divided by 3x square minus 2x minus 25, and the last one is linear. Linear means we need to take only one constant. So e upon x plus 10. I think by this time you are well aware of writing the partial fractions, and then after writing the partial fractions you can integrate. So now we are going to do a problem based on this pattern.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.